हेलो फ्रेंड, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट वन ऑफ द रिसेप्टर दैट इज फोटो रिसेप्टर. सो फोटो रिसेप्टर इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द विजुअल एक्टिविटी. सो ए पर्सन हु कैन सी थ्रू द विजुअल रिसेप्टर. सो वन ऑफ द विजुअल रिसेप्टर इज आई. सो इन ह्यूमन वन पेयर ऑफ आईज are present, which is responsible for binocular vision. So, eyes situated in orbit or eye socket, and it is small inside of spherical and forward directed structure. So, it is protected through the eyebrows, eyelid, upper and lower, and eyelashes, and also contain glands. So, glands called lacrimal gland, meibomian gland, and Zeis gland. Lacrimal gland secretes watery substance called tears, and meibomian gland is oily secretion which help in the free movement of eyes or eyeball. So now we start the structure of eyes. So this is the spherical structure of the eye. So it should look like a spherical structure. So eye which contains three layers. So outer, middle and inner layer. So outer layer is called excretory, middle layer is and major part of the eye is choroid, and inner layer is called retina. So we start from the outer layer, escleretic. So escleretic is non-vascular opaque layer, and at interior it become bulges and form a transparent structure called cornea. Cornea, which is white in color, and cornea, and above the cornea a layer, membranous layer, is present called conjunctiva. Any defect in conjunctiva called conjunctivitis occurs through the virus. So this is all about escleretic. And now we come to the choroid. It is the middle layer, 2/3 of the eyes, which is choroid. It is a vascular layer where blood vessels and nerves are present. And above the anterior to the choroid, a ciliary body is present. So ciliary body, which contain ciliary muscles or salivary muscles, divided into circular and radial muscles. So anterior to the ciliary body, a structure called iris, or in between two iris lens, are situated, which is connected to the suspensory ligament. And iris is colored or pigmented structure, or in between. So in the area of iris, a space called pupil, which helps in maintain the intensity of the light and entering the amount of light into the eyes. And above the lens, a chamber is present. That chamber is called anterior chamber, or filled with aqueous humor. And the chamber present behind the lens called vitreous chamber, and which contains vitreous humor. So this is the structure, middle structure of. Now we come to the inner structure. That structure is called retina. It is a nervous tunic structure which contains both nerve as well as sensory cell, and also contains photoreceptor cells. There are two types of photoreceptor cells: rod cells and cone cells. So rod cells is rod cell structure. Cone cell is the conus structure. So which help in the responsible for the day and night vision. Day and night vision. So this is, and on the area where nerves are started, that spot is called blind spot, where both rods and cone cells are absent, and a small depression just present when the eyeball end. That depression, small depression, is called fovea centralis, also called yellow spot, where only cones are present. So this is all about related to the eye. This is the structure of the eye. So there are three layers of the eye, and all about the how the These structures are systematically arranged and how it control and receive the light and enter the light. And next we discuss about the mechanism process for how the arrangement of the rod and cone cells with the nerve cells, and one of the special cells special nerve cells are connected and which help in the proper transmission of the light and goes to the brain, and we can see the images in proper way. So this will be discussed in next class. Okay, thank you.